Neera Tanden is, of course, Biden's pick to lead the Office of Management and Budget. And Joe Manchin, a Democrat, spoke out against Neera Tanden, saying that he would not vote in favor of confirming her. But the Biden administration is fighting hard to get Neera Tanden confirmed, to make sure she has some position of power within the Biden administration. And that certainly brought up a thought that many people are sharing across the country, which is, why is Biden and his administration willing to fight so hard to get an awful woman who has all sorts of conflicts of interest confirmed into his cabinet when he's not willing to put up a fight for a $15 an hour minimum wage? His White House press secretary was asked that question, and let's see if you're at all persuaded by her answer. Take a look.
The White House doesn't have 50 votes to confirm Neera Tanden as OMB director, and yet we heard from the White House chief of staff say that the White House is, they're going to fight their guts out, fight our guts out was the phrase he used, to get her confirmed. So why push for that and not push as hard, one could say, for raising the minimum wage?
Well, I think that's mixing a few things kind of irresponsibly, if I'm just being totally honest. I would say on the minimum wage, the president included a raise of the minimum wage in his package because he felt strongly that it's long overdue, that men and women working hard, trying to make ends meet, shouldn't be living at the poverty level. That's why he put it in his package. There is a process that it goes through, a parliamentary process, when it's a reconciliation bill, as you know, but for people who haven't been following all the nitty gritty of this, because it's a budgetary bill. That's why it went through the process. And, you know, again, I would send you to talk to leaders in Congress to see if they have the 50 votes necessary. But regardless, the president, the vice president have made the decision they're not going to move forward with that step. But also, it's not a simple process. It requires two steps. As it relates to Neera Tanden, she is somebody who has decades of experience. She is qualified. She is prepared to lead the budget team. And we're continuing, of course, to fight for the confirmation of every nominee that the president puts forward. We'll see if we have 50 votes. That's part of the journey. That's part of democracy in action.
Cenk, you sit back. I let you go on your rants today. It's my turn because that video is so infuriating and I'm about to go off. So first of all, nice little scold you have there for a reporter asking you a legitimate question. Referring to his question as irresponsible is the same kind of tactic that Trump and Trump administration officials would use to basically communicate to reporters that they don't like those questions and maybe you should shut up. Now, obviously the Trump administration was a lot less subtle, but the scold there was pretty clear. And I don't think it was an irresponsible question at all. It's one thing for Biden to say he's in favor of the $15 an hour minimum wage. It's something completely different to actually fight to get it passed through his relief plan. Noting that an unelected Senate parliamentarian doesn't think it's such a good idea and then refusing to overrule her does not show that Biden is in any way willing to fight for a $15 an hour minimum wage. On the other hand, with Neera Tanden, he is willing to fight because they're not dropping it. She doesn't have the votes, bro. She doesn't have the votes. Let it go. And when you cite her years and years of experience, what are we talking about exactly there when it comes to Neera Tanden? Are we talking about years and years of experience in government, in trying to find ways to pass legislation without hurting future generations? No, that's not what her experience is. Her experience as the head of the Center for American Progress has been to cater to the needs of business interests. The Center for American Progress served as a laundromat for the kind of lobbying that we've been railing against on this show for years. What that think tank did was take the money that these corporate lobbyists want to pay directly to bribe our politicians. They pay the Center for American Progress instead, and then the Center for American Progress lobbies on their behalf. And since they do it in that way, it's much easier to keep that money in politics dark, meaning that it's harder to track that kind of government corruption and influence by business leaders. That's what Neera Tanden's years of experience is. That's who the Biden administration is willing to fight for, but they are not willing to fight for you to ensure that you're getting paid a minimum of $15 an hour for the work that you put in. Okay, so that's what the reality of the situation is. And I'm so sick of people pretending as if when it comes to the bread and butter issues, when it comes to the fundamentals in this country, whether it's taxation for the rich, whether it's foreign policy, whether it's ensuring that we protect workers, Democrats and Republicans do the same thing. Democrats just put a polite face on it. But at the end of the day, Biden is not willing to fight for a $15 an hour minimum wage, but he is willing to fight for a corrupt woman who tried to cut Social Security to serve as the head of the Office of Management and Budget. That's what the reality of the situation is. And Jen Psaki, as the White House press secretary, needs to get a little better at framing things so she's at least a little believable, because that right there was garbage.
All right. So first of all, I want to give credit to somebody, and that's NBC News White House correspondent Jeff Bennett, who asked that question. That was an excellent question. And so look, we're tough on the press all the time here, but when they do well, I love giving credit. So the reason why it's an excellent question is in the case of minimum wage, you go, well, Manchin and Sinema are going to vote against us. There's nothing we could do. Nothing we could do, right? On the case of Neera Tanden, well, the same Joe Manchin is going to vote against her. So why are you saying that there's something you could do? So is there something you could do about Joe Manchin, or isn't there? Because you said that on minimum wage, there's nothing you could do, and you're going to fold immediately. And you said there was a giant priority. In the election, Joe Biden did not campaign saying, I'm going to put Neera Tanden on my cabinet. If you elect me, Neera's going in, right? Never, right? But he said, I'm going to do $15 minimum wage. I'm going to raise your wages. He said it 1,000 times. It was a core promise. So when on your core promise, Manchin says no, and there's nothing you could do. On a colleague, corrupt or otherwise, that you like, you're like, oh, there's everything I can do. No, I'm going to keep fighting. No, your priorities are super clear. And Psaki's answer was total crap. And it was terrible in two different ways. One, Anna's 100% right. When she was definitely threatening him there, you put it, that's an irresponsible way of putting it. In other words, you better watch yourself, or I might move you back in the press room and not take as many of your questions. That's the implication of using that word. It's bullying the press, and they should not give into it. So great job by Jeff Bennett in the first place. Now, the second reason why it's a terrible answer is for the reasons that Anna went through and I just went through. Look, and I have a lot of credibility on this for reasons that probably enrage some of our viewers, because I thought they should fight for Neera Tanden. Why? Because I like Neera Tanden? No. Some of the things, tweets she got in trouble for were mean to, well, all the tweets were mean tweets. Some of them were about me. Okay, some were about Bernie Sanders and people that we really, really like. And she did do all the things that Anna told you. So why did I think they should confirm her? Because I don't want Republicans and Joe Manchin being the actual president. I don't want them dictating to a Democratic president, here's who you're allowed to have in your cabinet and not allowed to have in your cabinet. I agree with that principle. I'm consistent though. I think you should fight Republicans and Manchin on Neera Tanden, and you should fight Republicans and Manchin on minimum wage. If you make me pick one, that's the easiest choice in the whole wide world. The $15 minimum wage, who cares about Neera Tanden? If you're gonna fight on principle, at least fight on the thing that matters, that affects 32 million Americans, that would give them a $92 billion raise every single year. Instead, you're going to go protect Neera Tanden because you want to do business as usual in Washington, D.C. So it's not that you're not willing to fight. It's that you're not willing to fight for us. And that's really damning.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.